Spirit.
Good morning, everyone. All those persons who are listening in on their Citizen Band radio, and all those who have been watching Mass join us on YouTube or Facebook. In these peculiar times, testing times, it's important that we take time each day to pray to God for hope. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May the venerable exercises of holy devotion shape the hearts of your faithful, O Lord, to welcome worthily the Paschal mystery and proclaim the praises of your salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me to the entrance of the temple, where a stream came out from under the temple threshold and flowed eastwards, since the temple faced east. The water flowed from under the right side of the temple, south of the altar. He took me out by the north gate and led me right round outside, as far as the outer east gate, where the water flowed out on the right-hand side. The man went to the east, holding his measuring line, and measured off 1,000 cubits. He then let me wade across the stream. The water reached my ankles. He measured off another 1,000 and made me wade across the stream. baptize me. It was now the river which I could not cross. The stream had swollen, and it was now deep water, a river impossible to cross. He then said, "Do you see, son of man?" He took me further, then brought me back to the bank of the river. When I got back, there were many trees on each bank of the river. He said, "This water flows east down to the Arba and to the sea, and flowing into the sea, it makes its waters wholesome. Wherever the river flows, all living creatures teeming in it will live. Fish will be very plentiful, for wherever the water goes, it brings health, and life teems wherever the river flows. Along the river, on either bank, will grow every kind of fruit tree with leaves that never wither and fruit that never fails. They will bear new fruit every month, because this water comes from the sanctuary, and their fruit will be good to eat, and the leaves medicinal." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, "The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our stronghold."
The Lord of hosts is with us, the Lord of Jacob is our stronghold.
God is for us a refuge and strength, a helper close at hand in time of distress. So we shall not fear, though the earth should rock, though the mountains fall into the depths of the sea.
The Lord of hosts is with us, for all the Jews are strong.
The waters of the river give joy to God's city, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within, it cannot be shaken. God will help it at the dawning of the day.
The Lord of hosts is with us, for all the Jews are strong.
The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come, consider the works of the Lord, the redoubtable deeds he has done on the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Please stand to hear the gospel.
Glory to you.
Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now, at the sheep pool in Jerusalem, there is a building called Bethsaida in Hebrew, consisting of five porticos. And under these were crowds of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed. One man there had an illness which had lasted 38 years. And when Jesus saw him lying there and knew he had been in this condition for a long time, he said, "Do you want to be well again?" "Sir," replied the sick man, "I have no one to put me into the pool when the water is disturbed, and while I am still on the way, someone else gets there before me." Jesus said, "Get up, pick up your sleeping mat and walk." The man was cured at once, and he picked up his mat and walked away. Now, that day happened to be the Sabbath, so the Jews said to the man who had been cured, "It is the Sabbath, you are not allowed to carry your sleeping mat." He replied, "But the man who cured me told me, pick up your mat and walk." They asked, "Who is the man who said you pick up your mat and walk?" The man had no idea who it was, since Jesus had disappeared into the crowd and filled the place. After a while, Jesus met him in the temple and said, "Now you are well again, be sure not to sin anymore, or something worse may happen to you." The man went back and told the Jews that it was Jesus who had cured him. It was because he did things like this on the Sabbath that the Jews began to persecute Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
The response to the prayers of intercession today is, may the message of Christ in all its richness live in our hearts.
May the message of Christ in all its richness live in our hearts.
Let us pray to God the Father, who gave his own Son, the Word made flesh, to be our bread of life.
May the message of Christ live in our hearts.
Father, may we hear your voice this Lent and pass with Christ from death to life. May we celebrate this Easter feast with great joy and love.
May the message
of teach us to live by your Spirit and help us to bring faith to those who doubt. May the knowledge of Christ penetrate our minds and our hearts. May it find expression in all our ways of living. Purify your church in these days of salvation. Make her the living witness of your presence in the world. We pray for all who are poorly in mind or body, at home or at hospital, for all those who are receiving treatment of one kind or another, for those recovering from or preparing to undergo surgery. We pray through the intercession of Our Lady of Lourdes and Saint Bernadette that they may be strengthened, encouraged and sustained, particularly in their time of greatest need. We pray in a special way for all those families, particularly in our own parish, who are mourning the loss of a family member. We pray at Mass this morning that God will replace their loss and sense of desolation with his very own divine consolation.
May the message of Christ in us, which is living in our hearts.
We pray for all those throughout the world who have been affected by this coronavirus. We pray in a special way for those who have fallen ill as a result of this virus, and for those who have lost their lives. We pray too for all those whose livelihoods have been affected by this coronavirus, and we pray, as I said at the beginning of Mass, that a vaccination may soon be found.
May the message of Christ and all his churches live in our hearts.
We commend to God's infinite mercy all who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith. We pray in a special way this morning for the happy repose of the souls of Dan Lee, Owen Rankin, James Creaney, Bridget Reynolds, Sue McNally, and Frank Reed, all of whose anniversaries occur today, and we keep in our prayers those who died of recent weeks, remembering especially Eileen Doherty, Eddie Stewart, Sean Keenan, Bradley Creed, and John Ridley.
May the message of Christ in all churches live in our hearts.
Let us pray. By our Lenten prayer and observance, Lord, prepare our hearts to welcome the mystery of Easter and to proclaim the good news of salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for good, for the good of all his holy church.
We offer to you, O Lord, these gifts which you yourself have bestowed. May they attest to your care as our Creator, for this our mortal life, and effect in us the healing that brings us immortality through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And lift your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise, we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord of God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his assistant bishop, Sean, our retired bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have deemed for your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Patrick, St. Bridget, St. Columba, St. Macartney, St. Malachy, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with Saviour's command is formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter over my roof, but only say the words of my soul shall be.
nothing I still want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he me repose. Near rest of waters, he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. O sovereign and holy, O sovereign and divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment now. O sovereign and holy, O sovereign and divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment. O sovereign and holy, O sovereign and divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be unto thee. O Sacred Heart of Jesus,
I place all my trust in you.
The Immaculate Heart of Mary,
pray for us.
And for protection today. O angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love can be seen here, ever this day be at my side. Archbishop Newman has asked that all priests in the Archdiocese pray this extract from St. Patrick's breastplate. So we pray, Christ with me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right, Christ on my left, Christ when I lie down, Christ when I sit down, Christ when I rise, Christ in the heart of everyone who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks of me, Christ in every eye that sees me, Christ in every ear that hears me. And we pray this little prayer which we printed in last weekend's bulletin, this prayer against the coronavirus. Most glorious Queen of Heaven and Mother of God, you whom the Blessed Trinity has crowned with unequalled glory, you are the sovereign Queen over all God's creation. We place ourselves and all our loved ones on the power, protection, and sovereignty of your crown. Under the protection of your crown, your corona, and through your immense intercessory power, we ask you to spare us all from the effects of the coronavirus. Dearest Mother and Queen, more Mother than Queen, we, your children in Christ Jesus, ask you to obtain for us an end to the spread of the virus. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
Let perpetual light shine upon them.
May they rest in peace.
Amen.
May their souls and the souls of all the faithful depart, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Purify our minds, O Lord, we pray, and renew them with this heavenly sacrament, that we may find help for our bodies now and likewise in times to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And just before the final blessing, let the people of the parish know that Father Clark and I are praying for them every day, and we would ask you to remember us. Tomorrow, Father Clark and I will join Archbishop Eamon, at least in spirit, in consecrating Ireland to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We will be doing that at 12 o'clock here in the parish. And we invite you to listen in or to watch on Facebook or YouTube as we consecrate our country to the Immaculate Heart of Mary to protect us from this coronavirus. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Hail, King of Heaven, the Lord. Star of the Sea.